Hi, we're here in Boulder, Colorado with the mountain bike world champion, Ruthie Matthes, on her porch. And Ruthie, I want to know how it feels to be number one.
It's very satisfying. It was a goal that I worked very hard for last year. And at the same time, it's a little bit scary. I've never been in this position before, but I hope that I'm a good ambassador for the sport this year.
You made the transition from road racing to mountain bike racing really easily, and that's kind of a change for a lot of riders. They're having a more difficult time of it. Why do you think that's so for you?
I think part of it is I spent a childhood running on trails, and I also was a ski racer, and so that's helped me a lot in the transition. And I think desire. I have a great desire to be a top mountain bike racer. I cross train in the wintertime, cross country skiing and hiking and goofing around.
Inline skating?
I'd love to get into inline skating.
You're training now for the Olympics. How much is that cutting into your mountain biking?
I could safely say I'm torn right now because I would love to go to the Olympics. When I was younger, I wanted to go as a ski racer, but I never made it. And so cycling is my second chance for the Olympics. And I enjoy high pressure events. I enjoy them a lot. And so I think that's why I'm driven to try and make the Olympic team too. My fiance rides for Coors Light.
And you guys train together sometimes?
Yes. When we're in town together, we do train together, yeah.
How's that help you?
Dave is a gauge for me. He really helps me know when I'm tired, and he pushes me hard when we do go out on a run. He goes a little bit faster. It's like, you can do this, okay. So he's my very best training partner. Tom Ritchey has formed a company of many bicycle products. He's the designer of frames and components, and we exclusively use his parts. And I think his mountain bike is great. Of course, I ride for him, but regardless of that, I really like the feel of the bike and the way it handles. He has a long history in mountain biking. I think he was one of the original pioneers taking up one speeds near Mount Tam. And the team went on a ride with him this spring. We had a training camp out in Redwood City, and he lives up on Skyline, which is above San Francisco, that whole area. And we went on the greatest mountain bike ride with him. It was really a blast. And I think that in the future, we'll be doing more rides with Tom.
Tell me about your first experience on a mountain bike.
I will never forget my very first ride. I borrowed a bike, and this had to be like 5 years ago. And the guy said, let's go do a hill climb. It's a race. And so I jumped on this borrowed bike, and I did this race, and I got like fifth. And I beat all these people. I beat all these men, and they got all bent out of shape. But then we went on a ride after that, and one of the girls with us flipped over the handlebars. And I remember being on the brakes almost the whole ride, and my forearms hurt so much for the next like week. I thought, I'm never riding a mountain bike again. This is just too brutal. But I got into mountain bike racing basically in 1990 because we got a road sponsorship for Ritchey road bikes. And they said, well, you guys have to ride the world championships in Durango. And I was like, oh no, you're kidding me. Oh geez, we have to do ride the world. You know, this is outrageous. And we were supposed to qualify doing some Norba national races, and I'd never fit them in. So I show up at the Worlds, I just come back from Japan, and I was like, I can't believe I'm doing this. And I jump on my mountain bike and I got a bronze medal, so. I've been explaining to people how in mountain biking, the final sprint is in the first 100 meters. You know, so it's backwards from road racing. The road racing starts out slow and builds and builds and builds, and the mountain bike racing is absolutely the opposite. You start out as fast as you can go and you hold it, and you just hope that you've got time on your competitors, and then you can, you know, get to the finish line.